Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. For fans of horror and the macabre, I'm going to show you how to create a flaming skull. For your convenience, I provided this skull PNG file for you to download. Its link is in my video's description or project files. If you prefer to use your own photo, just cut the face out from its background and copy it to its own layer. I covered how to cut and copy images in many of my tutorials. I also provided this image of flames that we'll use later. Open the skull file. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white, click this icon or press D on your keyboard. Invert the colors by clicking this icon or by pressing X. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Gradient. Open your gradient presets. If you don't see this set, click the gear icon and click Reset Gradients. Click this thumbnail. Make the style linear, the angle 90 degrees, and the scale 20%. Check Reverse and drag the gradient up approximately this much. Then click OK. To remove any of the white gradient that may be inside the eye sockets, click the layer mask to make it active and open your brush tool. Make the brush size 125 pixels with a hardness of 0. Make sure the opacity and flow are both 100%. Brush inside the eye sockets to reveal back those areas of the skull. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize and make the hue 200 and the saturation 40. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively, as well as allow us to replace our subject with a different one without having to redo the effects that we'll be adding to it. To do this, shift-click on the skull to make all the layers active, and click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. Make two copies of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Name the top layer Blur and click the eyeball icon to hide the layer. Rename the middle layer Multiply and change the blend mode to Multiply. Make the top layer visible and active and change its blend mode to Overlay. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Make the radius 5 pixels and click OK. Go back to Filter, Blur, and Motion Blur. Make the angle 90 degrees and the distance 100 pixels. To save space in the Layers panel, let's collapse the blur effects by clicking the small arrow on the right. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill the empty layer with white, and since the foreground color is white, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Change its blend mode to Overlay. Make a copy of the layer and change its blend mode to Difference. Name the top layer Difference and name the second layer Overlay. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Color Balance. In midtones, make the yellow blue 30. Open the tones and click highlights. This time, make the yellow blue 50. This makes the midtones and highlights warmer in color. We're ready to add the flames. Make the top layer active and open the flames image I provided, or you can open your own flames image. To place it onto your skull document, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the Skull tab. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the skull and release. Change the blend mode to screen. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the flames. We'll be making a few copies of the flames layer, but first, let's place the flames and its layer mask into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Name the folder Flames. Make the flames layer active and make 3 or 4 copies of it. Hide all the flame layers except for the bottom one, which we'll make active. Drag the flames over the eye sockets and forehead. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it in or out. Holding Shift kept the flames retain its aspect ratio. To reposition it, go inside the Transform and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. To remove areas of the flames, make the layer mask active and make sure your foreground color is black. Press B to open your brush tool. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard and then brush over areas to mask them out. We'll place more flames over that area to finesse it. Make the next flames layer visible and active. Open your Move tool and drag an area of the flames over the part you want to finesse. Make the corresponding layer mask active, open your Brush tool, and brush over the areas of those flames you want to mask out. Make the next flames layer visible and active. Open your Move tool and drag areas of the flames to the bottom left. If you want to resize it, open your Transform tool and drag it over to resize it. Then press Enter or Return. Continue these steps for your other flames until you're happy with your final image. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.